Number two on quiz one.
Number two on quiz one, find the exact value of the sine of pi over four?
Yeah.
Okay, so sine pi over four. Now, actually, that question is like the little quiz we took. Remember, there were two questions and they were just like this one. So what do we do first? 180 divided by 4. So this is the sine of 45 degrees. Right? 180 divided by 4. So then we draw a picture, right? And we remember, I'm going to go ahead and do this like we did on our little quiz. This is our setup. We want 45 degrees, so that would just be right here in quadrant 1, right? That's 45 right there. Right? So we know that the sides of a 45, 45, 90 are 1, 1, root 2. And since we're in quadrant 1, we don't have to worry about anything being negative. So we're ready to answer the question. We want the sine, and the sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So your answer would be 1 over root 2. Okay? Who else had a question about the big quiz? Any question on the, any other questions on the big quiz? Some of you didn't do so great, so you sure there's no more questions about the big one? All right, what about the little one the little one we just took? Anybody have a question about that? Brittany, which quiz and which problem?
Quiz 3, number 2.
Quiz 3, number 2 says it's exactly like this question Dylan asked about, except it's the cosine of negative pi over 6. But we're going to do that problem just like this one. So we'll start by doing the figuring out what negative pi over 6 is. So negative pi over 6 would be what? Negative 30 degrees. So now, this is a negative angle. So remember, that changes things a little bit. This is still zero, but now we're going down. So this would be negative 90, and I'm not going to need to go any farther because it's negative 30. So it would be right here. This would be negative 30 right here. So butterfly bow tie it. This is a 30 degree angle. It is the angle formed by the zero line and the negative 30 line. So that's a 30. So this is a 1, this is a root 3, and this is a 2. Right? Anything negative? I'm not in quadrant 1. Something's going to be negative. What's going to be negative? 1 is going to be negative. We want the cosine, so the answer will be adjacent over hypotenuse, root 3 over 2. Anybody else have a question about your little quiz? Good on the little quiz.
Can you take a quick look at
it? No, I will on the class. Okay. All right, now let's look at this practice quiz, which is our next quiz. Now, to give us more practice, I went ahead and gave two columns, but the actual quiz that you get is going to be half a page. It's going to be 3 problems. So the quiz is going to look just like this. Okay? So, but we have extra practice here just for the heck of it. So here we go. Pay close attention because you have to be able to do this by yourself on Monday. This is the last thing that we've talked about together. Okay? Now, we're going to do this Mrs. Ford's way, because it's just so much easier to just do what I tell you to do there. We're going to draw a sine curve. So we need a hash mark here and a hash mark here. And then 1, 2, 3, 4 hash marks, right? And we have memorized, hopefully, certainly by Monday, that a sine curve starts at the origin, goes up, crosses, down, crosses. This is a picture of the sine curve. Right? Now that much is automatic. Every sign you draw is going to look like that. What you have to do now is make adjustments on the labels. So what do you think these labels are going to be?
3 and -3.
These are your amplitude. Your amplitude is 3. And notice on the quiz, I've asked you for each problem, the period and the amplitude. That A stands for amplitude. So the amplitude is 3 for this guy. Now, what are these labels supposed to be? In the regular world, these labels would be what?
90, 180, 270, 360.
Just like they are on this circle right here. But those are not going to be the labels we use on this axis because that guy right there. So I have to take each one of these numbers and divide by 1/5. Right? So on your calculator, you can do 90 divided by 1/5, or you can do 90 times 5. If you do 90 divided by 1/5, make sure the 1/5 is in parentheses or it won't work. I would just do 90 times 5. So this first one is going to be what, 450? 900, 1350, 1800. So the period of this particular curve is 1800 degrees. Now I told you, or maybe I meant to tell you, these are all degree measures here. And I'm kind of lazy and I don't always mark them degrees, but when I write my period, I should get in the habit of saying, yeah, that's a degree measure. These are all degrees too, but I'm a little lazy. Okay, next. Now we've got a cosine. Now we are going to do exactly the same thing in terms of setup. The only difference is the shape that I'm going to draw. This is a cosine. In addition, I have to pay attention to this, right? What does that negative do? Flips it. So a regular cosine, I have memorized that a regular cosine has that shape. When I flip it, instead of starting up here like it would normally, it's going to start down here. And it's going to cross, peak, cross, end. And there it is. Now that much is automatic, right? Every cosine, well, negative cosine, is going to look like this. Now we have to adjust our labels. Any idea what amplitude is?
3.
Oh, yeah, it's 3.
So does that negative, other than flip it, does that?
Has no impact on anything.
No. Okay.
Other than it flips it. The amplitude is 3. So -3 and 3. Now, the labels I know are supposed to be just like before, 90, 180, 270, 360, right? Those are what the labels are supposed to be. But I stuck a number in there. So that means these labels have all been divided by that number. So my new labels are 22 and a half, 45, 67 and a half, and 90. Are those right? So what's my period?
90 degrees.
Done. Now we got our tangent. And a lot of you like the tangent the best because it doesn't involve as much arithmetic. But you have to remember that the tangent has a different shape, right? Different setup. It has an asymptote here and an asymptote here, and it goes through the origin. So there's a picture of my tangent. Every tangent you draw that's positive is going to look like that. Now, what about the amplitude of that curve? There is no amplitude to the tangent curve because
there's no height.
There's no ceiling and floor. In order to have amplitude, you have to have a ceiling and floor. Janae.
How do you tell
We haven't done this yet. I mean, we haven't labeled those yet. For a tangent curve, the asymptotes always go, it goes to the origin. So you always got an asymptote here and an asymptote here. We haven't figured out where they are yet. We know where they're supposed to be.
Yeah.
In the normal situation, where are these asymptotes?
90.
Negative 90 and 90, that's right. That's where they are normally. But what happened? We got to divide them by 2 because of that 2 right there in the problem. So my asymptotes are at negative 45 and 45. What's my period then?
90
degrees. The period is start to finish. How far did you travel from negative 45 to 45 is 90 degrees.
But you always start at 90.
The asymptotes are negative 90 and 90 in the regular tangent curve. Janae?
So the 3 doesn't mean anything?
Nope. It changes the curvature, but we're just doing raw sketching, so it doesn't impact us. All right. Now, one more of each. 1/2 cosine, 1/2 x. Here we go. This is a cosine. So the setup for cosine. There it is. Here's my cosine. Remember, I gave you a whole sheet of practice problems. You might think about doing that over the weekend. It is part of your homework to be turned in. Okay, labels. Here we go. What are my vertical labels on this guy?
1/2.
Because of this right here, these labels are 1/2 and negative 1/2, which means my amplitude is 1/2. If it were just a regular old cosine, I know the labels would be at 90, 180, 270, 360. But there's 1/2 right here hooked to this x. So these all have to be divided by 1/2. And 90 divided by 1/2 is 90 times 2. So this is 180. which means my period, start to finish distance, is 720 degrees. Sine curve. So notice it has a negative in front. So that means my sine curve starts at the origin. It goes down first. Everybody catch that? You got to pay attention to the negative, right? So your sine curve is going to look like this shape. Now what about labels? Vertical will be 2 and negative 2, which means your amplitude is 2. Notice, like Zach said, the amplitude is not negative 2. All that negative does is turn my picture upside down. All right, horizontal labels should be 91, 82, 73, 60, right? But what's in the problem that's going to mess that up?
You're dividing it by 2.
I'm dividing it by 2. Remember, we are always on our horizontal labels, we are always dividing by that number. So my labels are at 45, 90, 135, and 180. So my period is 180 degrees. Negative 1/2 tan 1/4 x. Okay, this is a tangent curve. So the basic setup for a tangent curve is this, right? Now what do I have to pay attention to before I sketch it in? It's negative. There's a negative here. Which means instead of doing what a regular tangent does, which is go up, it is going to go down. Just flip-flopped. I know that my asymptotes are supposed to be at negative 90 and 90. That's where they're supposed to be. But I stuck a number in here. So it's 90 and negative 90 divided by a fourth. That's 90 times 4, which is 360. So negative 360, 360. Bailey, this is a tangent curve. What's my amplitude? There isn't one. What's my period, Bailey? Distance from beginning to end. How far is it from negative 360 to positive 360? How far is it from negative 360 to 0? That's here to here is 360. How far is it from here to here? So what's the total distance? Thank you, Bailey. It's 720. Does that make sense to you, Bailey? It's 360 to here and another 360 here. So it's a total of 720. 720 degrees. So your quiz on Monday is going to look just like this. Going to have sine, cosine, and tangent on it.
Going up 3.
3. I said that already. So it'll look just like this. Okay? We just practiced 6. Because we're super practicers. All right. Now we need to take a few more notes.
woke you up.
That was your turn.
Yeah, I woke you up. I said, "Where's the recording?" And you go, "What, you with me?" I did wake you up. So, this dude fell asleep in English class.
Because she had the lights off?
Okay, who cares? And he starts snoring, and I wake him up, and I go, "Bro, you were snoring." He says, "Why did you wake me up?" I just woke you up.
I don't know, what time we were in the freaking...
Her class has been so boring so far.
Section 4.7. 4.7. And so we're on the back of page, 37? The back of page 37, so you want to get that out? Are you ready? Back of page 37. And we are going to find the exact value. Now, listen. This cost some of you some coins on your quiz. Exact value means no calculator. Because what usually happens when you type something into your calculator, what kind of an answer do you get? Some 0.5837691. And in order to write it down, you have to round it off, right? If you round it off, it is not exact. Are you following what I'm saying? So anytime the directions say exact, the implication is no calculator. So we're somehow going to answer all of these questions without a calculator. Now, how do we do that? Well, a couple of them are easy. There is one additional piece of information I need to give you, though, before we can do all of them. Actually, two things. First of all, I have to remind you, we've already talked about this, but I need to remind you that anytime you see this notation, it says to you, find the angle. When you see this little negative one, it is saying to you, find the angle that has a sine value of 1/2. So it's saying there's an angle out there and his sine is 1/2. Tell me what that angle is. Now, you actually already know how to do this. This one's not one of the hard ones. This one's easy. I want you to think about your triangle. And I want you to think about always this angle right here, right? That's the angle. Always the one at the origin. And the sine is 1/2. So what does that mean if the sine is 1/2? It means this is 1 and this is 2? It is not 45.
That's
right,
3 at the bottom.
This is a root 3 at the bottom.
Oh, yeah, it's not root 2.
So this guy is a 30 because the 30 is the one that's across from the 1 always. So what is the angle that has a sine of 1/2?
30 degrees.
The answer to the question is 30 degrees. That's easy. That's easy. Let's look at B. B says, find the angle whose cosine is root 3 over 2. Now, I'm not going to write that out anymore. I expect you now to start thinking about when you see this notation, it means find the angle. So here we're going to find an angle, and this time the cosine is root 3 over 2. So I'm going to draw my triangle. This is the angle right here that I'm looking for. And the cosine is root 3 over 2. So what does that mean?
It's a 30, 69.
It means this is a root 3 and this is a 2?
Yep.
So that one's going to be a 1. Oh,
yeah, 30.
It's 30 again. The answer to the question is 30 degrees. The next one says find the angle whose tangent is root 3. Now, the ones that have plain numbers, like just root 3, I like to put over 1. It helps remind me. Root 3 over 1. So I'll draw my triangle. Here's the angle. Root 3 over 1. Kia, you paying attention? You sick? Did she say uh-huh? No? Okay, well pay attention then. So root 3 over 1, which means the hypotenuse is 2, and the angle I need is 60, because 60 is across from the root 3. Those are easy. D is where they get hard. And not hard, I just have to give you some extra information. What's different about D?
Negative.
It has a negative. And what the negative means, kids, is you are not going to draw your triangle in quadrant 1. Does that make sense to you? That if there's a negative involved, you can't draw it in quadrant 1. As long as the number is positive, you're going to draw it in quadrant 1, just like you always have, and that's fine. If it's not in quadrant 1, you have to know where to draw it. And unfortunately, it's different for the different functions. So, if you're doing a sine problem, and this number is negative, it doesn't have to be negative 1, that number is negative, negative anything, you're going to draw it in quadrant 4. If it's a cosine and it's a negative, you're going to draw it in quadrant 2. And if it's a tangent and it's negative, you're going to draw it in quadrant 4. On this 4, how am I going to remember that? I don't know.
So cos is on 1.
So sine and tangent are in 4. Cosines in 2. That's exactly right. And we only worry about this if that number is negative. Right? So, since this is a sine and it's negative, I'm going to draw it in quadrant 4. So my triangle is going to be drawn in quadrant 4. The sine is 1 over root 2, right? Opposite over hypotenuse. I have to put the negative somewhere. You'll never put it on the radius, right? Of the hypotenuse. This guy is never negative. So that must be negative. Does that make sense to you that it would be negative? Yeah. And then this side would also be 1, but it would be positive 1. What angle is that? 45. But be careful, it's not positive 45, it is negative 45. Why is it negative 45? Because it went down, right? If you're in quadrant 1, you're going up when you draw it. This one came down. So the answer to the problem is negative 45. Oh, Brittany's watching the clock.
That's great.
I know.
Oh, no.
All right, let's try the next one. angle whose cosine is negative 1/2. All right, Q. The angle whose cosine is negative 1/2.
What quadrant is this?
What quadrant?
Yep. This is gonna be in quadrant two.
Come on now.
I didn't know, it's still up there.
And the cosine is -1/2. Does that labeling make sense to you with a cosine of -1/2? So this side over here would be √3.
It's a 60.
The angle is 60. That angle right there is 60, right, folks? That angle 60? But what would the answer be? Negative 60 would be down here. This angle is actually 120 degrees. The answer is 120 degrees.
Times 2.
No. Now listen. When we label our angles, we label them like this, right? This is how they're labeled. Where does every angle start? Right here. You got to get all the way over here to this quadrant, right here. So the answer has to be something between 90 and 180. It has to be. That's the setup, and it never changes. So we're between 90 and 180. If that's a 60, that means the distance from here to here is 60. So doesn't that have to be 120?
Yes.
Yeah, lots of thinking to do, Jay. So,
how do you know if it's a 60?
You have to memorize your triangles. Memorize them. So you know across from the root 3 is a 60. You just got to memorize it.
Yeah.
Never changes.
So, Ms. Ford, that last one was a 45, and but that, because it was on the right side, it was only 45. The one was on the left. Remember that one? How that degree was only 45 degrees?
Because it's 1/1 root 2.
Yeah, but
since it's on
the right side.
Here are the labels.
Yeah.
That angle went down. So it has to be between 0 and negative 90.
Yeah.
It's a 45 degree angle between 0 and negative 90.
Yeah.
Makes it negative 45.
Okay. I was just seeing it. Yeah.
So where we did that without even realizing it.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know exactly what you're talking about, but yeah.
Like how it became 120 in the second one.
Like, why do we not...
What would you say that answer should be if it's not 120?
I would have said 60.
You would have said 60 degrees.
Yeah.
Okay, it's in quadrant
but
two.
Now I know why.
Yeah. It can't be 60 degrees in quadrant two. Because every angle in quadrant two is between 90
like
and
C, like it has to be
180.
Because it's in quadrant.
Yeah, but our question was why was the 45 in the previous one? Why didn't that become like 90 or something?
Why wasn't this answer 90? This angle would be 90? I mean, I don't even understand the question. Because a 90 degree angle would be this whole thing, Zach. Obviously, that's only part of it, so it couldn't be 90.
Yeah, but that's only a 60 degree angle right up there.
Yes. That angle is 60.
But it's in
the second quadrant. Zach.
That was in the fourth quadrant.
Stop. Just stop. Okay, look up here and open your mind and just think for a minute. I must start here. This is where I start measuring. How far is it to here?
90.
I got to get all the way over to this quadrant.
Yeah.
That would be 90, right?
Yeah.
Now, you just told me that was 60, so wouldn't this part here be 30?
Yeah.
So I have to go 90 and 30 more in order to get to that line.
Yeah.
So how far did I go?
I didn't go all the way around.
120. Now, over here, I start here at 0, and I'm in quadrant 4, so I'm going down.
Yeah.
So the answer, I'm only going 45 down. I'm starting at 0 and going down only 45. I'm not going all the way over here, or up here, you know, somewhere. I'm just going 45.
Yeah.
So if I start at 0 and go down 45, how far is that?
Negative
negative 45 because I went down.
Okay, I see it. Mike, I was saying, like, I thought you would go all the way around.
Yeah. Start here and go all the way around and say your answer might be 315.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Okay, in these definitions, an additional component of the definition, which we don't need to know, if we just know we're going to start here and either go up or down, okay? An additional part of the definition is something called the principal values. Every answer to this question has to be between negative 90 and 90.
All right.
So if I went all the way around, I would totally agree with you that 315 would have a sine value of negative 1 over root 2. That is exactly right.
Yeah.
The problem is 315 is not in that interval. If you typed into your calculator second sine, this number, it will say negative 45. It won't say 315. It will say negative 45 because it follows these rules. If you typed in this on your calculator, it will say 120. Could it have said negative 240? Sure, that's the same angle, but that isn't what it's going to say because it has to follow the rules. And the rules are, and we're talking only now with negative numbers, because otherwise it's in quadrant one. If it's a negative sign, you're going to go down. It's going to be in this quadrant. So it's going to be negative 30, negative 60, negative 45. If it's a cosine, it's going to be in this quadrant. And you're going to have to go all the way through quadrant one and then into quadrant two. So this answer for a negative cosine is always going to be something between 90 and 180.
Okay.
Always. Okay. All right, so now we're going to do a tangent. Now, the rule for tangent is exactly the same as the rule for sine. So we're going to draw it in quadrant four. And this right here is going to be my answer. That guy right there is my answer. I'm not going all the way around. I'm going right here. That's my answer. So my tangent is negative 1 over 1.
45?
So the hypotenuse would have to be root 2, and that's a 45? If you say 45, you're going to be wrong, though, because it went down. So it's negative 45. Those are the rules.
So for the one up there that you have to count all the way from like 90 to the line, so you would add 90 plus 30 for that one?
I don't, because my triangle was built on 180, so I do 180 minus 60.
Okay.
But if you want to go ahead and figure out, okay, that's 30, it's 90 plus 30, yes, it's going to get you in the same spot.
Okay. I know.
All right. I know. Now we got another sign, but it's a positive, so that's good news. So I'm just going to go ahead and draw my triangle in quadrant one. Why am I drawing my triangle in quadrant one?
It's positive.
And if that number is positive, you're always going to draw it in quadrant one. So sine is root 3 over 2. So this is a 1. And how big is the angle I want, which is the one at the origin?
60.
That's 60. So the answer is 60. That was pretty easy. Uh-oh, here's another negative cosine. Okay, so this is one that had us confused. Let's even figure this out. It has a negative cosine, so I'm going to draw it in quadrant
2.
And it's negative root 3 over 2.
Yeah.
So that would be a 1.
30.
So this angle right here is a 30.
So that would be 6.
Now remember, this is 180 right here, right? But you're only going this far. So what would this angle be?
150.
Kids, the whole thing is 180, right? If you stop 30 before you get there, it would be 150. Another way to think about that is, if that's 30, this guy here would be 60. So you got 90 and 60 more, that's 150. So the answer to the question is 150.
Zero.
Your phone's ringing.
That's not my phone.
It's the phone on your iPad.
Did you say your phone?
Now we've got two tricky ones. Here's what I want you to think about. Think about the other problems that we did, like on yesterday's quiz or the other quiz we took. When there's a zero involved, we're always talking about these angles right here, right? Aren't these the ones that have the zeros? So these from the unit circle, when there is a zero involved, you know you are looking for one of those angles. All right? Now, it's a tangent.
Was it in the first quadrant?
That means 0 over 1, right? So let's start at 0. We're going to work our way around, okay? We're going to work our way around until we find the right one that gives us a combination of 0 over 1. Now, in order to know that, you have to remember that tangent is the y over the x. So we're going to start right here at the beginning, at 0. We're going to work our way around until we find the combination that gives us 0 over 1. Okay? So right here, let's start right here. Does that give me 0 over 1 when I put y over x? Guys, if you put y over x, what do you get? 0 over 1, which is what we wanted. We found it. The answer is 0 degrees. It's this angle right here.
It's just 0.
Just 0. Now, if that hadn't worked, we would have gone to this one and tried to see, okay, does this one give me 0 over 1? And if that didn't work, we'd go to this one, and we just keep working our way around until we find the combination. All right, now this problem. And I'm not redrawing my picture. This is the same picture I use for every single one that involves a 0. Right? So here we go. What is sine? You gotta remember the definition. Y over R. So we remember that R is always 1. So we've gotta go again, start right here. Start at 0. This is 0. This is 90, and so on. At this point, if you put your Y over your R, you put your y over your r, what do you get?
Zero.
Y is 0. 0 over 1. Isn't that what you get?
Yeah.
Yep. So this answer is also 0. Now let me do one that's not 0, because both of those turned out to be 0. So let's suppose we have something like oh, how about this? Cosine negative 1. Alright, so I want you to remember what's cosine? X over R. Right? And R is 1. So you go around your circle until you find the point where you can put X over 1, R is 1, and get negative 1 over 1. Does that happen here?
No.
No. Does it happen here?
No.
No. Does it happen here?
Yeah.
Yes. So what's the answer to the question?
180.
That angle is 180. So that answer would be 180 degrees. Brittany, I don't know why it's X, the X coordinate over R. R is always 1. So that would give me negative 1 over 1, which is what I'm looking for. For these problems, guys, as you work around the circle, you just try each one, and as soon as you find the one that works, you're done. So our first two examples happened to be 0, so we were done. We didn't have to check anymore. For this one, we had to keep going because we didn't find it until we got to here. You're going to find the answer here, 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 or here every time. For those. Okay? All right. Let's see how much time do we have. You guys have far the clock.
3 minutes.
All right, let's do one graph review problem.
No, 2 minutes.
Like to get us back in graph mode because that's where we're heading on Monday for our quiz. So let's graph a cosine. Negative 4 cosine 1/3 x. Here we go. Let's see how you can do. We have 2 minutes. We can get this done.
So we
got to
times our
90. Okay, now wait. Let's get our framework set up first, right? So hash mark, 1, 2, 3, 4.
-4.
It is a negative cosine.
Flip it.
So it starts down here. It has this shape.
4, -4.
Amplitude numbers are 4 and negative 4, so my amplitude is 4. Now, my horizontal labels should be these, but because of that, I'm going to divide everything by a third or multiply by 3. So that would be 270. 540, 810, 1080. So my period is 1080 degrees. Everybody got it? This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
Oh my God, my collarbone still hurts. I broke my collarbone in my sleep.
Shut up!